And good evening and welcome to the ASCATDEMY Awards. I'm Joe Lynch. I'm the host of Greatest Somerville here on SCAT TV, the co-anchor of Somerville Neighborhood News, along with the beautiful, gorgeous, smart, and talented Melanie Morris off to my right in the yellow jersey.
Melanie!
Where is she? I like scaring her that way. So it is, I'm also on the board of directors here at SCAT TV, and it is my pleasure to be asked to return as co-host for tonight's ceremony, where we honor and recognize the best of the best of SCAT TV and Boston Free Radio, where the award recipients go home happy, and those who did not win ask, who the hell voted for those schmucks anyway? And where I, as a gay old white guy, likes to desperately stay relevant in 2017. Our honorees tonight light up our channels, feeds, and internet with some of the most diverse, new, live, collaborative, ensemble-filled, arts, music, and cultural-themed, youth-created, advocacy, and informational shows this side of Donald Trump's tweets. The statuettes we'll be handing out tonight, designed by our very own, the late great David Ortega, and fabricated, I should say, by the super talented students at the Somerville High School Fab Lab.
Woo, woo! Yeah!
Yes, yes, yes. They are not, contrary to rumor, medical devices, Daily Baker, or should they be used as adult toys, Peter Levine? They are a union of, and an homage to, a somewhat ambiguous human torso, a microphone, and our own neighborhood landmark of the Prospect Hill Tower. Hence, we call these the Prospies. I know, it's clever. It's strange, but it's clever. But that's SCAT TV. And now on to the awards. The first Prospy of the night is for the best new SCAT TV show. The recipient is the Heavy Leather Topless Dance Party, and accepting that award is the creator Ken McIntyre with his crew.
That I wanted to make a TV show with the most hated band in town, which is these guys, Strange Fighter. And that's what I did.
Hey, it's not on. There you go.
Thank you. And I'm very proud of these guys, and these are the producers of the show. And honestly, so the very first show we did, 3 minutes into it, We almost destroyed the studio and we knocked out the power for half of the building. Remember, Jason? That's how the show started. And we figured, well, can't get any worse than that. And then the first time we did the show here, there was like blood and nudity, and it was just a mess. But we have persevered, and here we are. And I haven't seen all the other new shows, but I'm sure we are deserving of the best. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations, guys. You know, Ken. Yeah. Ken is fairly new to the scene here down at SCAT TV, but I did get an email from one of the executive director of Cambridge Television, who said she remembered Ken clearly, and I thought to myself, how could you forget? So, you know, some of you may have seen a public service announcement that we did when we announced that we were having the ASCATDEMY Awards, and I tried to teach Ken a little bit about how you promote your shows and how you promote things. Adam, do we have it? Can we roll it?
Hello, I'm Joe Lynch from Greater Somerville and Somerville Neighborhood News.
And I'm Ken from the Heavy Weather Topless Dance Party. And we're inviting you to Somerville Oscars.
Let's try it again.
The 2017 Somerville Academy Awards. The 2017 People's Choice Award. The 2017 Somerville Country Music Award Show.
Hi, I'm Joe Lynch from Greater Somerville and Somerville Neighborhood News.
And I'm Ken from the Heavy Leather Topless Dance Party. Please join us for the 2017 ASCATDEMY Award Show.
We're right here at the SCAT TV Studios, 90 Union Square, Somerville, on January 19th, 2017. Hope to see you there.
Check it out. Join us.
This is comic gold right here.
Good job, Joe.
How about more comic gold? Can I see a show of hands or some applause? Can I bring Ken McIntyre back up here?
Yeah!
For Ken! Come up here, Bobby.
See, I told you this wasn't. Honestly, they thought
he doesn't realize when you're hosting, you have to speak into a microphone.
They're telling me they were wireless. I knew they weren't wireless, man. Magic. All right, hey, so right, we're going to give out.
You're going to have to be a couple of things, brother.
Yeah.
You got to be careful of the wires.
Sure.
Yeah, because yep. I'm half wired right now.
Right.
So that's what comes with starting these shows too early.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Because then I sit out there in the lobby and I kiss and I glad hand and I drink. You think you can handle some of this
stuff? I can absolutely handle it. I wish I had some water, but hey, what kind of music did we have for me coming up? Can you give me a little?
You know, I think there you go.
All right, thank you.
It's very Phantom of the Opera.
Yeah. All right.
So what we're also going to have to be careful of is this sliding podium.
Okay.
Because you're going to wind up in one of the recipients' laps. So. How about if we get started? You know, you did such a great job on the PSA. You want to try the first one?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
By the way, I'm really not that stupid. The whole thing was scripted, really. All right, here we go.
Woo!
And by the way, so we're doing a thing where there's no winners or losers, right? Everybody's just a recipient. I don't really agree with that, but it's not my job to. All right, so are you ready?
You're up.
Yeah. Okay. And the recipient. I'm gonna start here, right?
Yes. Yeah. Right here.
Right. And the recipient for the best Boston free on-air radio DJ. By the way, did you know that I was on Boston free radio for 6 weeks in the summertime after we got thrown out of EMF?
That's very pleasant, but this is the winner's night.
Okay. Right. Okay. And exactly.
Recipients.
And the recipient for the Boston Free Radio On Air DJ of the Year, Cole Rosengren! Yeah. Yeah. Come on up!
Woo! I got screwed!
I'm not Cole.
He's not here, so I'm accepting this on his behalf. This is for you, Ken.
Oh, thank you.
So his show is Techno Trash. It's amazing. He likes techno, and he's a trash journalist, so. Really cool mixture of stuff.
All right,
man, I'm gone.
All right, thank you. All right, now I'm over. Okay, I got it.
So don't believe anything Peter Levine says. He's a news producer, and it's fake news. Our next award of the evening is for Best Live TV Show Host. And that award goes to Crystal Chandler.
Crystal!
Yeah! Woo! Yeah!
I don't, and I've never lived in Somerville, but everyone in Somerville has really embraced me, and this definitely feels like home. And thank you to all the staff, Jason, and of course, thank you to Missy Beck. Can we give her a round of applause? She's the one who brought me in here and was like, hey, I'm going to throw you on camera, and here we are almost 2 years later, so I definitely appreciate it. And check out our show. We're live Friday nights from 8 to 10, Somerville Line.
Thank you. Next.
So we go down the list.
Okay.
How's that?
Wait a minute, so I'm doing all the reading and you're doing all the handling?
No, you're doing, well, we switch off.
Okay, got
it. I'm a good handler, you're a good reader. You want to try it that way?
The recipient for Best Live TV Show. It's Dead Air Live, everybody. Ricardo Pineda and Charlie Tesh. Come on up. Enough to go on.
My introduction to public access TV back in 1975 was reading in the newspaper about how a guest on a live TV show called Dead Air Live had been arrested in the studio for trespassing. An invited guest in the show to the show was arrested for trespassing. I thought that was pretty bizarre. But it kind of woke me up to the idea that there actually was a TV studio in the city that anybody could come down and use, and other portable equipment stuff to make shows. And my feeling at the time, as part of the sort of counterculture, you know, was that, well, the media that we have is really not telling the story. And we need to get down there and try to do some of that on our own. And that's what we did. And I could just like to say it's fabulous to see so many people here, a full studio, standing room only and beyond, and so many people who are involved in doing this. And I'll just end by saying that I think this is probably the most crucial time in the history of the country that something like SCAT exists.
Yes.
And I hope it continues strong.
Yes.
So moving along, we are into the BFR portion, or we're going to mix it up. The best Boston Free Radio music show goes to Joe Vig's Pop Explosion.
Wow, you people are awesome here. This is like the most incredible TV radio station. I'm really humbled, and you know, to foster creativity, because we creative people are crazy. And you're crazy, but it couldn't be done without Heather Mack, without Brianson, without yes. Jason Corey, yes. without Adam Stone, who's been amazing. Yes. Thank you, Adam. Yes. Erica, Alan James Patterson, and I have crossovers. Ed Robleski's out in Agawam, but he meticulously listens to the station and calls the station and keeps us aware of what's going on. So, I mean, it takes a village, and we are a village, and I just want to thank everyone. It just means the world to me, and being part of this little family, it means a lot to me. Thank you very much.
Okay. Well, speaking of Susan Freshman, she knows me because I did a show in 1993 at CCTV called Welcome to Weird City. It was a great show.
And you were only a kid.
I was, yeah.
So was I.
And right.
Keep agreeing with me and you that can my, stay up here.
My sister threw out all the master tapes, so there's no proof. But it was there. It happened. All right, let's get to the next point to which you want to do now.
So that was Joe Vick.
Okay, that was Joe Vick, right. Okay.
A one clue about being a host.
Yeah.
You have to bring a pen with you.
Oh, my
because
God.
Then I have you something can cross it out.
Hold on, I have something to show you.
You
hold
got
on.
It?
1 second.
What is it?
Yeah, I have a pen. Look at this pen.
Whoa.
Hold on, hold on. Wow, look at that.
Right here.
Lights
right
up.
In the front.
Lights up. All right, here we go. Best Boston, this the recipient for the 2017 Best Boston Free Radio Talk Show, everybody. It's Listen Lyndon. Lyndon Marno Frey. Come on, Lyndon. Oh, Lyndon. You will accept this award.
You will.
All right, I will accept it for...
Couldn't get the vacation time because she's about to go on like a big epic vacation and she had to work tonight, but she's very grateful for this award. Chad and Lyndon on every Monday from 7 to 8, I knew that. You should listen to it. It's awesome. They give advice. It's all mostly good. And so you should tune in to Listen Lyndon Monday 7 to 8. And thank you.
Thank you, Heather. Thank you, Heather. There she goes, Heather Mack, everybody.
I love how all the staff jumps up here to get the award. So moving on is our next award for the best collaborative project. And the award goes to Beyond Boston, Jason Prima of Binge, the Boston yes. Institute for Nonprofit Journalism.
I'm very pleased to accept this acknowledgement, hat tip, or prop, because I guess it's not an award.
All three.
All three. on behalf of Chris Verone and my other colleagues at the Boston Institute for Nonprofit Journalism, and I just wanted to give a big shout out to Erica Jones, who obviously isn't here.
Erica!
For conceptualizing the idea of a regional news digest show, which is being syndicated all over eastern Massachusetts now, and it's been doing really well. And Sam Beltrusis for refining the idea. And Sam's actually syndicating his own show now, right? Called what?
What's New Massachusetts?
Right, which is airing on SCAT.
Yeah, at 6 o'clock, right before your show.
No plugs.
Awesome.
Go ahead.
And Brian Zipfer, supporting the idea, and all the folks at the participating stations, Cambridge, Malden, Brookline, Watertown, and more coming. So thanks.
All right.
So I am going to do the next one only because it's unfortunate that the recipient cannot be here, but. The next award goes to the Best Arts and Culture Program, named Fallon's Daily Toast. Fallon Lee O'Brien is the creator, producer, and host. Unfortunately, Fallon is on set. She's on location in Paris, but she has asked her twin sister, Lee Fallon O'Brien, to accept the award on her behalf.
All right.
Lee Fallon O'Brien.
Paris, so I'll just take this here.
All right.
So as I said earlier, that we are voices in a time, and the birth of a movement is upon us, and it's crucial, as the man from Dead Air Live says. We're living in very strange and perverse and demented times, and we need not normalize. And I really believe wholeheartedly that this place is so paramount to have this kind of facility, and we're so grateful. You know, Fallon's Daily Toast started in the North Country. I got my first computer when I was 31, and I was sitting like in Easton, New Hampshire, farming, and like opened it up and I'm like, what's going on? You know, nothing. There weren't any news outlets that were talking about the farmers markets or the, all the cool stuff that was happening. So I'm like, I'm gonna start my own show. And at first it was Fallon's Daily Dose, and then I'm like, oh, then people might take that a little weird. Dose and what, Fallon? You know, I don't need to like bring any weird attention. Anyway, Fallon's Daily Toast. So Fallon's Daily Toast, you know, it came just for me starting, you know, wanting to share what was going on in the community. And my sister passed away 2 years ago, and it brought me down here to Massachusetts, back down to Mass. To Mordor, I like to call it sometimes. But I do love it, and it's I love it because of this place. I love it because of Somerville, because of the community, because of all of you. It's truly so special to be in a community that's like, shows so much love and care and appreciation and compassion, and that is what we need. And so I feel it, that what happens here ricochets out to the world. You know, like, do you ever feel like what you do has like a little things, all those great little things that you do, this task, this, you know, it moves outward. So let's keep up the good work, all of us. Keep, you know, fighting the systematic oppression that keeps perpetuating, right? Like, yeah. We need to like hold accountable our representatives and like legislator and put some more pressure, and television and radio is a way to do it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. There she goes, everybody. Finally, she's like my seventh or eighth favorite person in the world.
Top 10.
Next up. You know what, Joe? I really hope that I can be a guest on this show someday, based on the title. Best Boston Free Radio on-air ensemble cast winner 2017, Isabel Gutierrez and Charlotte Somerville, fantastic, for Death is the Final Stage of Realizing Things.
You know what, we can trade.
Yeah! Congratulations!
Yay! Say something with the microphone.
I guess a friend of mine told me that we should prepare a speech, but then we didn't. I feel like usually on air we're really charming and funny, but there is usually about 5 minutes
really
in the
funny.
Beginning. Yeah, really funny. 5 minutes in the beginning where we don't really say much of anything.
Mm-hmm. Our friends rag on us for kind of going on and on, like
we're doing now.
Yeah,
we can sing the theme song really quick.
Okay, right? We used to love one another. We used to do each other. Love fire cover. So are you friends?
There are no replacement trophies. You break it, you own it. And on another note, the next Prosby goes to the Best Advocacy Program, and that is for the program Somerville Overcoming Addiction, Joanne Ravicchio. Joanne was here earlier, and the program that she does is all about recovery. Whether it's about recovery from drug and alcohol abuse or other types of illnesses that people suffered through day in, day out, Joanne and her co-host are marvels when it comes to bringing in people who know about substance abuse, who do the right thing, and advocate for health, policy, and education.
And that is Judy Walker, Judy Walker is a co-host of that show. And I want to thank you all for Joanne and Judy, and they just do a tremendous job every Monday night. You're more than welcome to come join us live in the studio, or if you have any questions, concerns, you're more than welcome to email them. They're on Facebook, Somerville Overcoming Addiction. Thank you.
Hello, hey, okay. All right, Joe.
You're getting the swing of it.
Yes.
As I've always said, the youth, the kids, they're the future, pal. Everybody knows that. Not us. The past.
So let's do something for the kids. Time, everybody, for Best Youth Created Program here at at Somerville Cable. The 2017 recipient for Best Youth Created Program is UNews/Villains News Network. Heather McCormick, creator. Yeah! Woo! Embarrassing joke.
Heather Willis.
Wow.
She will? Will she do that now? No, she won't do that now.
Depends on where she is.
Okay.
We'll hold it for her.
She's on the
phone. We'll hold it for us. She might be on the phone. So the next part of the awards program is going to be for SCAT TV Special. And the best SCAT TV Special for 2016 is the Hassle 24-Hour Telethon. Oh. We have somebody accepting the award for the 24-Hour Telethon. We will accept on their behalf. I think it was probably Erica Jones who was going to be accepting, but Erica has the bubonic plague. So we're just going to move on because she may not come back, so we'll just hold the award. We're going to do the next one here, and Ken McIntyre, if you can help me here.
Sure.
Yeah, we're on to Best New BFR Radio Show.
With the hassle, so I was hoping to confront
them. Oh, that's not good. Because I took my jacket off. All right. Let's move on.
We are a professional organization here at SCAT TV. Aren't we, Ken?
Are we on to the Innovation Award? Is that where we're?
We are.
Yeah, we're going to.
Best New BFR Show.
BFR. Innovation
you
Award.
It yet.
Yeah, okay. No. I got the innovation. Heather. Who's got the microphone, man? The recipient for the 2017 Innovation Award. It's Snooze, everybody. Stuart Roke. And the Snooze Crew. There they go.
This is a little awkward. As you know, we already accepted award and said we were canceling, but we just had a quick discussion. We've decided to come back due to popular demand.
We're doing the snooze. Just really quick, I'd like to have a somber shout out to Weatherman Everywhere. Weather isn't funny. And thank you to Aeronaut, Ben, for the free beer. Delicious.
Woo! Free beer!
Everybody at SCAT for hosting this game.
Thank you all.
Peter, Daly, and Kate, and Jennifer, and Monira, and...
Tessa.
Everybody!
Watch our show!
A hearty, hearty thank you from that crew. We're going to move on to the Best BFR Pre-Recorded Show, and that award goes to Talking Hendrix, Ed Wableski.
Ed
Hendrix!
Out in Western Mass and is disabled and wasn't able to make it, but that's why we gave him this award that he is our pre-recorded, one of our awesome pre-recorded shows that's local, and he is really, really grateful for this award. He does a lot of work, not just on his own show, but also helping with quality control for Alan's show and Joe Vig's show, so we owe him a lot of thanks, and I will accept this award on behalf of him.
Okay. You guys editing this live?
We are.
Thank you. All right, everybody, up next. By the way, this is my co-host right there, Foxy Chrome, everybody. She's a half an hour late, that's okay.
I was 10 minutes late.
All right, it's fine.
Busy doing science.
Sure. Hey, everybody. The recipient, 2017 recipient for the best new BFR, Boston Free Radio show. Oh my gosh, everybody, it's the Pop Culture Experiment, Patrick Garvin. Woo! Of the Pop Culture Experiment.
Thank you. This is basically every Saturday morning I just show up with some guests and we talk about cover songs and we geek out about pop culture, and it just sort of feels like the end of the night when you and your buddies are kind of arguing over like whether the Beatles versus the Stones or Like a Prayer versus Like a Virgin, and it's kind of just geeking out on stuff like that. Empire Strikes Back versus Jedi, and it's just a fun thing. And so thank you to Heather, to Erica, to Hans, to Adam, and to people who listen. So.
I do better on radio. Our next award is for the Diverse Voices Award, and that is going to the Somerville Line Event
Yeah. I want to thank everyone at ASCATDEMY. You've been tremendous. I want to thank Mary Beth, who's joined us in the audience tonight. She helped us out with hosting the Somerville Line when we first began, and then Ms. Crystal came on and continued on with making this a wonderful show. We're all about promoting and providing individuals with a platform, and I want to thank the ASCATDEMY family for bringing me in as a family member.
Hey Joe, in the summertime, we were on my other show, the Sleaze Grinder Super Show, was on the radio here at Boston Free Radio.
Yeah.
And we tried to have an on-air barbecue. That was our idea because it was July 4th. So we're going to try to cook hot dogs in the studio, which turns out we can't do.
Well, why not? You did an interpretive dance program on your radio show.
That's true. But they wouldn't let us barbecue in the studio.
No.
But Yvette helped us out.
We can change that for you, brother.
Yeah.
Anything you want to do.
Turns out you can microwave hot dogs, and they're almost...
don't give them that.
They're almost as good. Hey, everybody. Oh, boy, this is my favorite. It's time for the recipient for the 2017 Best Children's Program, Joe. You're not going to believe it. It's the Jeff Jam Sing Song Show. Jeff, come on up. Take us first. There you go. Now it's official.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank everyone who sang with me this year. But I'd especially like to thank this gentleman right here in the front room for his undying enthusiasm. Thank you, Jason.
I told Jeff I wasn't going to say this year, but you know, it does help that you're the only kids program on
Scott. That's not true. We had other nominees.
Yeah, Joe.
Show me.
I will.
On to the next award. The best out there Boston Free Radio show is Red Milk Row, Rob Rice.
Thanks very much. I didn't think I was going to win this year.
but I'm really proud to have. I sent in a audio clip.
No audio.
These
are the rules.
These are the rules, folks. Thanks very much.
Yes!
Sure, that guy is out there, man. Hey, it's time for, oh my goodness. Can you hand me the thing? Thank you. Why do I have this one if I'm talking into this one, Jason? Why do I need two of them?
It's a stereo.
You're the man.
Okay. Coverage. All right.
Everybody, this next one means a lot to me, Joe. Nobody deserves it more than this character. It's the 2017 recipient for the Best Informational Show. I don't know if that means that the information is the best or you're just the best at delivering it. But either way, the recipient for 2017, the show is Greater Somerville. And guess what? The creator is Joe Lynch.
Been a long time coming. Been a long show. This is my what? I don't know. I, you know, 10th, 11th, I mean, really. 8, okay. 10, okay. 11, that's weird. You know, we've had fun here tonight, and it's the final award of the night. But it is fun to participate with a bunch of professionals that work down here. And those professionals are Jason Corey. Erica Jones. Ellie Stone.
Anna.
Hans Elmendorf. Heather McCormick. And after the technical difficulties tonight, the late, great Brian Zipp. You know, we joke a lot, and you know, anybody who produces shows down here or who participates or who volunteers, our interns are superb. Our interns come from a lot of the universities and the colleges in town. They are studying either communications or they're studying anything that would have to do with delivering the news, delivering entertainment, delivering the arts. And we deliver it not for ourselves, we deliver it for the public. And I will have to say, you know, after being down here for about 8 or 9 years now, I don't do this as a profession, but I have more people talk to me, my friends, my circle of friends, more people talk to me about SCATTV than they talk to me about my personal life. It's like, how are things down at SCAT? You know that guy who sits in the front desk? And I said, the little white guy or the tall black guy? I said, we only have two who sit at the front desk. But you know, it's really important when you are recognized by your peers. It's very important when you have a professional staff to work with. I think I speak for all of the producers here, all of the directors, all of the hosts, that we get nothing but the best support in the world to do what we do to deliver our product to you. So I want to thank the staff. We are at the end of the program, and I want you all to give it up for my co-host for the evening, Mr. Ken McIntyre. What say you? Shall we have him back again next year?
Yes!
That pretty much concludes the 20... I missed it.
Yeah.
That pretty much concludes the 2017 ASCATDEMY Awards being brought to you by the Somerville Media Center. Watch for more information about our future programs. The Somerville Media Center is the proud parent company of Somerville Community Access Television, Somerville Neighborhood News, and Boston Free Radio. Everyone, thank you so much for your patience. Thank you for coming. We'll see you all next year. Thank you.